Hello everyone. In this video, let us look at the operator precedence and associativity in JavaScript. As you know, operator precedence and associativity is an important topic in C programming and Java language also, because that tells you how the operators are going to evaluate any expression. So if you want to download this presentation, you can go to our website, that is www.digimeta.com. Over there, you can go to the download section. From there, you can download the presentation, this PPT which I am using in this video. And if you want to check out our courses, you can also go to the courses section. So now let us start. So we have various operators in JavaScript, as you already know. For example, in C language also we have various operators. And with all these operators, there's some associativity is given with them, and their precedence is given. Let me give a simple example of operator precedence and associativity. I hope that you already know some basics of operator precedence and associativity, but still, for revision purposes, let me just give you a simple example. Let us say we have an expression which is 4 divided by 5 multiplied by 6 modulus 7 division 8 plus 9 minus 10 multiplication 11, and let us say plus opening brackets 12 multiplied by 0, if you have this kind of expression. Now in this expression, which of these operators is going to be evaluated first? That will be given by the operator precedence and associativity. In case of C and C++, and you can say in case of Java also, in these programming language, the precedence of multiplication, division and modulus is greater as compared to plus and minus. That means before evaluating the plus and minus, we are going to evaluate multiplication, division and modulus. And their associativity is left to right. That means if, let us say, we have A multiplied by B multiplied by C. So because we have two multiplications operators are there where precedence is same, therefore we are going to evaluate the left one first and then we are going to evaluate the right one. So we know what is associativity and we know what is the precedence. So if you take the same case here, so here you can see in this entire expression we have division, multiplication and modulus, and here also multiplication and division are there, and here also brackets is there. So obviously bracket is having higher precedence. But then in this entire expression, first of all, we are going to evaluate 4 divided by 5. Then we will evaluate multiplied by 6. Then we will evaluate modulus 7. Then we will evaluate this. And then we will evaluate this division. And then again here we are going to evaluate this. And then we have plus, minus and plus. So here their precedence is same. So associativity is left to right. That means we are going to evaluate this first. And then we are going to evaluate this one, and then we are going to evaluate this expression. So operator precedence and associativity gives us the way in which we are going to evaluate different kinds of expression. So first of all, we are just looking at the operator precedence and associativity table. You can mark the associativity of some important operators, but you don't actually need to remember most of them because they are very intuitive. So initially, this brackets and this dot operator, they are having the highest precedence. Highest means 1 and lowest means greater number. For example, if I rate precedence as 12, that means it's a low precedence and 1 is the higher precedence. And this is representing the associativity. Now you look at these operators. We have plus plus, that is an incrementation operator. So the precedence is 2. Associativity is left to right. Then we have decrementation operator. Then we have negation operator. Logical not, again bitwise not, then we have delete, new, type of and void. All these operators are having actually the same precedence. These are having same precedence. So the associativity is again right to left. That means if they come together, then first of all we are going to evaluate the right one and then we are going to evaluate the left operator. Okay. For example, if we have A, if we have logical not of A, and again we have logical not of A, in that case we are going to evaluate this first and then we are going to evaluate this one. So if two logical nots are together, so we are going to evaluate the right one, then we are going to evaluate the left one. Now for example, if we have a negation of logical not, or you can say the expression is something like this, negation logical not A. If these two operators are coming together again, their associativity is right to left. That means we are going to evaluate this one, and then we are going to evaluate this operator. So you should know the precedence and associativity of each and every operators. And then you can see modulus, multiplication and division also. All these three operators are having same precedence. These are having same precedence, and associativity is left to right. So for example, if you have A multiplied by B division C modulus 7. So if these are coming together, then again we have to evaluate left one first, and then we are going to evaluate the right one. So their associativity is left to right. And then we have plus, minus. So this is two kinds of plus are there. One is plus operator, which is a binary plus can be there. And then we have string concatenation. Actually, plus is of three types. So plus can be of three types. Number one, it can be a unary plus. Second, it can be a binary operator, binary plus. Or third, it can also apply on strings. So unary plus means if you have plus 5. So this is operating on one single variable. That is why it is a unary plus. If we have 5 plus 6, that means it is a binary plus. If we have string as 5 plus string as 6, so this is applying on the strings. So plus is of again of three types, and associativity is left to right. That means first of all we will evaluate the left plus, then we will evaluate the right plus. And then we have bitwise right shift and left shift. It is having lower precedence as compared to plus and subtraction. So this means from top to bottom these are having low precedence, and in bottom we are having higher in top we are having higher precedence, and in bottom we are having lower precedence. Okay, so for example, if you have A plus B and 3 like this, so this is a bitwise right shift operation. So here you can see we are going to evaluate A plus B first, and then we will evaluate this operator because it is having a lower precedence. In the same way, you can see the precedence of each and every operator here, because you need to remember some specific precedences only. You don't have to remember each and every one of them. I'm going to discuss about them, because most of them are very intuitive. Most of these precedences are left to right, but some of them are right to left. So we have to know where which operators is having right to left precedence and which operator is having left to right precedence. So for example, in the plus operator is again, it is behaving differently with different cases. So I'm just taking all these cases. So in the very first case, here we are using plus operator, and this is a string, and the second one is a number. So between a string and a number, so you can see here, this plus operator is going to convert this entire to a string. So the result will be 1, 2, that is 12 in the form of a string. But again, if 2 is in the beginning and then we have 1 is in the end, where 1 is a string and 2 is a number, so it is going to give us 2, 1, which itself is a string. So if in your entire expression, if you have one string, then so entire expression will be converted as a string. But the third case, you can see we have two pluses here. So as you can remember, plus is having associativity as left to right. Left to right means we are going to evaluate this first. So here 2 is a number, 2 is a number, so 2 plus 2 is 4. And plus, then we are going to evaluate this one. So this is a string, so it is going to represent 4 plus 1, which is going to be 41. So it is not going to represent 221. Because of the associativity. In the next case, see, we already know that plus is the only operator which can, if we have a string, so it gives a string. But all the other operators, that is minus, division, multiplication, right? So all these operators are going to convert a string to numbers. Okay, only plus is not going to convert it. So here we have the subtraction operation. So because of the subtraction operation, this will be converted to a number. So 2 minus 1 is going to give us a number 1. And here we have division operation. Therefore, this will be converted to a number, and this will be converted to a number. So 6 divided by 2 is going to be 3. In the next case, let us say we have a variable x, and here we are applying a unary plus. Unary means we are only applying on one operand. So we know that if we have operator and then we have operand, so it is unary. If we have operator plus operand, operand plus operator plus operand. So then it makes a binary. For example, if you have a plus b, so here it is a binary plus. If you have plus a, that means it is a unary plus. So here you can see 1 is x itself is a number, so it is going to give a number which is 1. If you let us say y is equal to minus 2, so minus 2 is a number. So when we do plus of y, that means it is just doing minus 2, that means it is not performing any operation. But here you can see, here this 2 is a boolean type, and if you apply plus before this, so that means this is going to convert this boolean type to a number, so it is going to print 1. And here you can see it's a string, and we are using unary plus here, so these are unary operators. So here these are unary operators and these are binary operators. So there's a basic difference between unary and the binary. Now here in this case, because it is a unary plus, so unary plus is going to convert this to a number which is 0. So basically it acts as a shortcut in some sense. So if you are using unary plus plus and this inverted commas, so this is equivalent to saying as number inverted commas. So it is just equivalent to saying a shortcut notation for number. So you can also use the unary plus as a shortcut notation for numbers. Okay. And then again, there's one more example here. You can see here, apple is a string which is storing a number 2. Orange is a string which is storing number 3. So if you do apple plus orange, so here because it is a string and it is a string, so this will result a string. And the string will be 2 plus 3 is 2, 3. Okay. Now, in the next case, I'm using single plus here. So this is a unary plus, and because it is a unary plus, so this apple will be converted to a number. And here it is a unary plus, so this will be converted to a number. So apple was storing 2 and orange was storing 3. So this will be converted to a number 2 and this will be converted to a number 3. So result is going to be 5. So you can use a unary plus as a shortcut notation for this notation. So actually saying the sentence which is a plus a p p l e s apples plus plus orange, this will be actually equivalent to saying number apples plus number orange. So these are equivalent because unary plus can convert a string to a number. And then we have special operator, which is assignment. So assignment returns the value. For example, here you can see we have a is 1, b is 2. So b is 2, so 2 plus 1 is 3. So a will be storing 3. And then this 3 will be returned. So 3 minus 3 is going to be 0. So for in c, we are going to store 0. And then we have the exponent operator. This is again a special operator. This is not present in C language. I mean, in this way. So here, this is representing power. Okay, so the first expression is representing 2 raised to power 2, the second expression is representing 2 raised to power 3, and third expression is representing 2 raised to power 4. Okay, and when you do 1 by 2, so the first expression is representing 4 raised to power 1 by 2, which is equal to under root 4, and the second expression is representing 8 raised to power 1 by 3, which is actually equivalent to cube root of 8. So this is an exponent operator which was not present in the original C language. In the same way, we have a comma operator. This is again the this operator is having the minimum precedence, as you can see in the precedence table also. The last operator here, the very last one here, it is comma. So comma is having the least precedence as compared to all of them. So comma is going to evaluate the multiple expression and it is going to result, give the result of the last expression. So for example, here 1 plus 2 is going to be 3 and 3 plus 4 is going to be 7. So we can have any number of expressions here like this, which are separated by commas, and it is going to take the last expression. It is going to give the result of the last expression to this. So if you print a, so a is going to return 7. So I hope that you understood the operator precedence and associativity. And it is one of the important topics here in JavaScript also, because there are some operators which behave differently in JavaScript as compared to other programming languages. I hope you understood this. Thank you so much for watching.